balloon, right?
Yes.
When you blow the balloon, white variables fit in the balloons until it's expand.
Yes,
particle. Right, class. Those who want to answer, please raise up your hand so everybody can hear you. Right? So, Young said it is?
Air
particles. And Nadira said it is?
Air
molecules. And Kelly, how about you?
Gas particles.
Gas particles. So, what are the difference between air and gas? Are they the same?
No.
Not exactly.
Air is filled up of several types of gases. Right. Whereas gas is?
It's just one gas.
Gas is?
One gas.
One type of gas. So how many gases are there in the air? Properties, and then you click on
Good morning to Puan Fazila and my fellow friends. So, as we all know, we just conducted the Boyle's Law computer activity. So now, let us all discuss together about the discussion on this activity. So, if you see here, the activity that we just conducted, you can see that it involves volume and pressure, and we saw how the particles move about in a container and how volume affects pressure and all of that. So the graduations that we used for the container on the ruler is 10 times 10 to the power of negative 9 meters. Okay, so when we conducted this experiment, the number of gas particles that we added to our container was 100 gas particles. Okay, and the type of gas that we added was heavy particles. Okay, so as you all would have observed in your own computers, the particles moved about. In my first trial, I got the volume of the container that I set was 261.36 times 10 to the power of negative 27. And the pressure that I got was, that the computer showed was 2013. So, with every trial, I increased the volume of my container. So, you see, the first one is 261.36, and the next one is 348, 435, and following is 522 and 609. So, as you can see, the volume of the container increases with every trial. So, when the volume of my container increases, you can see that my pressure decreases. Okay? So
your pressure?
Decreases.
Your pressure?
No, I mean the pressure of the gas particles in the container. Pressure of the gas particles. Okay, so the pressure decreases. Okay? So this is basically the application of Boyle's Law, because when the volume is inversely proportional to pressure when the temperature is constant. So in
wait a minute. Usually we don't come to the conclusion until we show the graph.
Okay,
which is our analysis.
Okay.
All right. Okay, continue.
Okay, that is the data basically. And then, so this is the graph. Can you all see?
Yes.
Okay, so this is the graph that I got it. So according to the data that we collected earlier, this is the interpretation of the data in the form of a graph. So you can see the shape of the graph that is...
Do you have anything to say about the data and how critical analyze the data? Anyone? Okay, Tashna?
I must have missed that when writing down my data, but just so you all know, for volume, I think the unit that we use is meter cubic, and for pressure is kilopascal. So I shall add that in. Thank you very much.
Alright, anything else?
My self picture. I would like to point out the part where on the graph, critical impact.
Okay, can you come?
Oh. It is somehow same to what Tasha said, it's just there.
In the graph, it's not in the
table.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We have something, but
more less. Pressure. So, graph A shows that P against B shows that the pressure decreases with the volume. This shows that P against B is inversely proportional.
Now, your hands. Go, set.
Go.
It's going for a set.
Four. 3, 2, 1.
I never get anything.
Boys, hey, you're loading for me, man.
Sunny.
Oh,
my
young.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
graph is an example of two variables
graph. What do you think about the lesson by using fact simulation? Anyone?
I really think it's very easier to learn. Like what you just said earlier, if you're just going to depend on a textbook, you do it, do it like the experiment, you don't really get it. Like when you had the quiz, I actually related it back to what our graph, like what Kitika did earlier. I imagined the graph in my head and that's how it worked. So I really think using these fact simulations make it easier, make learning easier for us. It's really enjoyable.
Anyone else? What is your perspective on using fact simulation? If you like it, we will use it for your next lesson. If you don't like it, so that's it. Okay, yeah.
Besides it's easier to use, it is also made learning very fun.
Yes.
Do you agree?
Yes.
Fun in what ways?
We can get to see, isn't it?
You see, it's very important to see the air particles. Because before we do not see the air particles. Right? Okay, now, one more observation. Okay, comparing the small particle and heavy particle. Okay, you do it at home. And then you include that in your report. What is the difference in terms of pressure when with the same amount of air particles, same temperature, but different types of air particles? You observe the difference in pressure. Alright, okay, I want to see your report tomorrow. That's all for now. Thank you, class.